Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease in which the body's own immune system destroys the cells in the pancreas called the beta cells that make a hormone called insulin that regulates the blood glucose. Patients today are treated by injecting insulin. Without insulin, the glucose just builds up in the blood, causes all sorts of damage, and in the worst case, the cells will starve to death. What we found is that the way that beta cells are regenerated is not from the expected location. For many years, it's been thought that beta cells regenerated from another structure in the pancreas called the duct. We believed that also for many years. But when we actually looked carefully, what we found, and this was published in a paper a few years ago, in 2010, was that it was a neighboring cell in the pancreas, a cell right next to the beta cell called the alpha cell that makes a different hormone called glucagon, which is related to insulin in controlling blood glucose. And these alpha cells, under certain conditions, have the ability to turn into beta cells, a process called transdifferentiation. It's just one cell type turning into another cell type. So that's what we found in 2010. And what we've been doing since then is working to move that knowledge towards the ability to control it with drugs. And so in our most recent paper, I think there are two major things that we accomplished. The first was to replace the complex surgical procedure that we used in 2010 with a simple peptide so that we can inject a simple peptide that induces this transdifferentiation or conversion process. The second thing that we showed in this paper that's, I think, very important is that we showed that this transdifferentiation process appears to occur not only in the mice that we all use as model systems, but in humans with type 1 diabetes. The answer to the question of how to move it into people is that what we need to do is not only develop a targeted therapy where we already have made quite a bit of progress, but we need to couple it with type 1 diabetes with an immune therapy so that we prevent the beta cells that we would cause to be made from being rejected again by this autoimmune process. And to that end, we're collaborating with an immunologist at the Institute who works specifically on trying to induce tolerance, immunological tolerance, to the reformed beta cells.
Well, our approach is to generate a very potent population of regulatory T cells to contain the autoimmune response that's occurring. And one of the ways we are able to do this is to treat the cells in culture to make them better, stronger, more effective. And also we have taken the approach of injecting antibodies that stimulate these cells in vivo so that they can better function at the time we inject them. It has been a long road to finding a cure for type 1 diabetes. There is a strong recognition that T regulatory T cells need to be targeted. In my collaborations with Dr. Levine, there are strategies now to induce the differentiation of those cells from progenitor-like cells or from other endocrine cells in the pancreas. And it is going to be this combination of approaches from the beta cell biologist and the immunologist that will be required to achieve a cure.